I'm very pleased to be here for this Asia Economic Dialogue because Pune is a very special place. It's a seat of learning, it's an educational center of excellence, and it's very important that issues such as trade and development and the participation of developing countries like India in the international trading system, in international trade, they need to get exposure in places like Pune and in states like Maharashtra, which is one of the most industrialized states, accounts for such a large percentage of the GDP of India. So I'm very, very happy that Pune PIC has taken this initiative to launch this series of dialogue, and I'm very pleased with the first one, which I've had the privilege of participating in. And I think our panel very much focused on both aspects of developing country participation in international trade. What is it on the ground? How much of a leap it has been since just 20 years ago? In developing countries now account for nearly 50% in terms of world merchandise trade exports, and also they account for a major share, 34% share in services trade. They also have become major recipients of FDI inflows, and also now as much as 41% in terms of FDI outflows. So these are real major leaps that have been recorded. And in that context, I've also tried to, and I think our panel members came in on that, we also tried to look at what is the political economic conceptual history of the participation of developing countries in international trade and trading system. And in that context, we set out some key concepts like center-periphery, globalization, beneficial globalization, and the whole concept of global interdependence and trade being a positive sum game. So all of those perspectives were brought forth. And I think we also looked at the China story in particular, or how China was a major factor. And of course, we looked at India and what strategies are important in that context to make India a major player in international trade. It already is very active in shaping the international trading system, but we really need to also be actors on the ground and become I'm not saying like China, but I do hope that we can have an Indian miracle the way the Chinese have managed to become the Chinese miracle in international trade and investment and technology. So that's certainly what is the aspiration that I would have. And this conference should continue. This dialogue. The other panelists will share with you their vision and in particular the challenges that developing countries face in the multilateral trading system, as well as in terms of regionalism, unilateralism. All of that was brought out very well, and we had a very wonderful question and answer session. Very interesting questions were asked. So all in all, a very good session and enlightening one. And we do hope that that Asian Dialogue 2 and subsequent follow-up dialogues will be held. And I'm not a great fan necessarily of Davos type of dialogues, because sometimes they tend to be too spread out and not focused. I like this format, and what I would hope is that in future dialogue we have more interaction with business in terms of getting across to them what's happening in these global processes, particularly the trading system, because this is about mobilization and getting together national stakeholders around issues that are of vital interest to us. Thank you.